Everyone, welcome to another session of AstroKid. Today I'll be showing you an interesting thing. So that is known as Taylorium, and let's see what it does. So Taylorium is an online software by which you can locate the position of stars, comets, or any other astronomical objects that you want to see. So here I am in the Taylorium website. As you can see here, you have two options. So one is the web version, which is the light version, which you can use it without downloading, and there is another version which you can download. So here you can see I am in this Taylorium, so it will track my location and then it will show me the current position of the night sky. So you can see when I do a full screen here, so it will show me the current night sky position, right? So well, I will not be using this for my work as I have already downloaded in my system. So let me go here and I'll just show you the Taylorium part. So you can see here the Taylorium is on now, and this is the screen of the Taylorium that you can see here. I'm currently using it in my MacBook, but you can use it in any Windows or Linux system. So what are the basic features of Taylorium and what all can you see? So the first thing that shows up here is the night sky with the Milky Way, and if you're using a mouse, you can use the middle scroll button to zoom in or zoom out to any object. So here you can see I'm just zooming out, and I'll zoom in to a particular star or a target as I want to study. So you can see here, and using your arrow keys you can focus on any of the targets that you want to know. So here I can show you one such target is Wyman. Clicking it on the target, it shows the coordinates of the target as well as the type of the star and the magnitude. So you can see this target here as it is shown, but I'll show you the other important features. So the first feature of this Taylorium is, as you can see here, once you go to the right hand side, it will show you a number of options. So we'll be coming to all the options one by one. So for the first tutorial, I will be showing you how can you set this in as your location. So first I'll be clicking on the location window, and you can see here there are a lot of locations given here. So usually when you open it, it will show you Paris as the default location. Well, if you are from Paris, that's fine, but if you're not from Paris, there are n number of ways by which you can change your location. So current location is showing in Africa, so I can click on this red mark and I can just put my location here if you want in this way. So it will show you list of cities which are in that location. So I stay in Kolkata, so I'll be just putting Kolkata here. So in case it's not showing you, you can just reset it and you can find out the Kolkata India. So I'll be just putting it in Kolkata India. It's not necessary that your city will always be there in the list of city. It may be a small city, so in that case you can use the latitude or the longitude of your location. If your country is not listed there, you can click on the country and then you can select your country and put your location. So this is one of them, and if you don't want this, then you can return to a default location. This is my current location, so I will be using this location as my default location. So once I'm set with my location, so let's see. Yes, this is my default location and I'll be crossing it now. So you can see here at the leftmost corner, it's showing Earth, Kolkata, and it's 11 meter. So it's the elevation, and you can see here the time is given in UTC. So it's showing 54, that means it's night, 1 o'clock almost. And here you can see the stars, and this is the current position of the night sky here. Well, Fomalhaut is visible, which is very interesting. That's one of my favorite stars. You can see the Jupiter out here. So we'll come to it one by one in later details. So also there's one interesting thing people were asking me about, how can I see the comet. So I will come to that also, that using Taylorium, how can you see. So first, how will you align yourself with it. So you must know which is the north, south, east, west direction in your location. So let's say you are in a current location particularly. So let's say this is the southward direction. So if you are able to align yourself with the southward direction, then you can find out all the targets that are in the southward direction towards you. So you can see in the south, if you look upwards, you can see Saturn, Jupiter and all other celestial objects. So you must align yourself and you must know which direction is your north and south, so that you can use this platform in a very lucid way. So let's move on to some of the features. So first feature I will be showing you is the date time window. So in case your date time is not correct, you can fix the date and time from the screen itself. So you can fix the date and time. I'm not changing because it is correct in my case, but if you want, you can do it. The other thing is that I'll be showing you, today is 16th July, so yeah, that's correct. And if it's not correct, you can change it on your own. So if you want the time to pause it, you can pause it, so the stars won't be moving, because as we know, the stars rise and sets in the night sky, so there will be a constant motion of the night sky. If you don't want it to move, you can see it's fixed now, but if you want to move it, so you can just move it and it will just keep on moving. So you can just fix it to the you can just fast forward the night sky time also, and you can see how it's going. So you can see I can just fast forward and will keep moving, the night sky will keep moving. You can see if you want to see what will happen throughout the night. So this is how, if you are looking in the southward direction, you can see that how the night sky goes off and then how the sun comes in the morning. So I'll be just showing you at 6 o'clock in the morning now, and then if I want to make it another fast forward, so yeah, so it's noon and then now night sky came back here. So I'll just be slowing it down. So this is how you can see the entire night sky if you wish to. So I'll not be, let me fast forward it to you once more. So the sun is not here in this side, so sun will be somewhere here, so you can see what all objects will come and go. So this is something very interesting to see. As you can see, this is okay, I'll show you another example. So this is the eastward direction, and let us go to the west direction, because as we know, sun sets in the west. So this is the west direction, and as you see, it's 11 o'clock in the morning. It should be at the horizon. Slowly by slowly, Venus is going down. So this is for the 18th July, as I'm showing you here. So you can see it's 2 o'clock, and then slowly by slowly, 3. So you can see the sun is setting down at the west. So I will pause here and I will go back to the current location or today's date here. So you can see here, if you want to see something more interesting, I can show you. So the first thing is this landscape. If you don't want this landscape and want to view the entire night sky, then also you can do it. So this is one of the thing here, so you can just pull here. So this is how the night sky moves in the westward direction. So there is no landscape. This is one of the most interesting features, where you can see how the night sky is actually happening, what all the objects you can see in a particular day or night. So this is the landscape option, where you can see the horizon. So up to how much you can see the night sky, that's very important actually, because if it is below the horizon, you won't be able to see the targets. So let's come to another option here. So you can see here, this is the, it shows some more stars and constellations. So you can see this is in a much farther details, it just shows. So you can see if you want. So if you click on a star, it will show you what type of star it is. So double star means there are two stars orbiting out there. When you click into a planet, you know what a planet is, all of you, I guess, those who are watching this video. So that's it. When you click on this equatorial and alt azimuth mount, so there is a difference between two. There are two kinds of telescopes. So one is alt azimuth and one is equatorial. So when I'm clicking this, basically I'll not be confusing you with you into the details of what it exactly means. So there are two kinds of telescope, one which can rotate in the alt and azimuth direction, whereas in the equatorial mount one part of the telescope is aligned exactly with the latitude of that place. So that is both the telescopes have, and both the mounts actually have an advantage and disadvantage. So just a second, I'll be showing you what actually does it do. So if you click on this, so it's basically you are at the equator and now you are looking as if the earth have a slope, right? So you can see there is a slope here, and since I'm in Kolkata is approximately 25 degrees, I'm not sure exactly, but it's around, the elevation is around 25 degrees. So let me check once what is the elevation of Kolkata. So it's 22, so it's just near the Tropic of Cancer. So you can see here the latitude is 22 and longitude is 88. So this angle is actually 22 degrees. It looks like to me it's 45 degree, but it's not. So the elevation is around 22 degrees, and so that's why this, as if the, it's like the earth is not in a flat position and the universe is like that. So if I'll just show you, if I do it in the first forward position, what you should exactly see. So you can see that the earth is moving, and then you can see the earth is rotating, the sky is constant and the earth is rotating. So you can see that, so it's facing towards the sun now, so it's in this direction. And now if I do it in the very first forward direction, so this is the daytime, and then after the day is over, so this is the night time again back. So this is how the earth is rotating. So it's 6 o'clock, 7 o'clock. So you can try out this feature again. So there's one more feature which I wanted to show, is the cosmic showers. So if you want to see any cosmic shower here, so you can also see that. Well, I'll try to show you if anything is possible. It's not always possible to cover everything in one tutorial, so I'll be going through various tutorials where I'll be describing how to use the software module in details, each and every module I'll be showing you. So here I cannot show you currently the cosmic showers due to some reasons. Okay, I didn't click this. So you can see here, these are the cosmic showers or meteor showers that is happening currently. So this is the generic data for the meteor shower. So there are a lot. So yes, somebody was asking me about the Meowsy comet. So I'll be talking about it in details in my next video. So till then, you try out featuring what do you want to see. So yeah, I'll not be showing it here now exactly, but you can keep on trying. But with this Stellarium software, it's very easy and helpful to use. So if you want to know the constellations, again I'll just, if you want to know the constellation, so what happened, just a second. So it's just showing me the stars and all. So this one, don't want that. I want, so it just the big screen. Yeah, so I just don't want, just a second. So if you want to see the constellation with the human figures, so you can see here, so there are 88 constellation and 12 of them lie in the sun's plane, or what we call the meridian plane. So you can see this is the constellation here. Well, in today's day, constellations are still important, because with that, if you are lost somewhere, if you can locate where is the Polaris or the pole star, then you can find out your location. Well, now I'll just be connecting the dots. Just a second, I just want to, so here it is. So if I, So this shows you the extra galactic objects also here. So you can see the star cluster and stellar clusters here. So along this, so this is the Milky Way. I hope all of you have understood. This blob of light that you are seeing here is the Milky Way, and in the Milky Way there are a lot of stars and galaxies. In the Milky Way there are a lot of star clusters, so that's what we can see. And also there are other galaxies also. So basically this option shows you the extra galactic objects. So you can see here, once I click it off, it just goes away. So I'm sorry for that, what I said before. Milky Way itself is a galaxy. There are other galaxies as well as star clusters available. So I apologize for that. So here you can see the different star clusters and double star clusters and what all are there. So here you can see the Andromeda galaxy, as I can show you. So this is the Andromeda galaxy. This is the nearest galaxy. So proper galaxy, not a dwarf galaxy. So this is the Triangulum galaxy, and there are a lot of interesting objects. Trust me, astronomy is a subject which brings us to the question about our existence, whether do we really exist, or like there are more civilizations like us in such galaxies. So maybe, who knows, somebody from the Triangulum galaxy or the Andromeda galaxy is watching at us now. Who knows about that? Let me move on. So I'll be showing you how to look into the constellation. So for that, I'll be just turning off the galaxies. And so this is Sun, of course, all of you know. So I'll not be wasting my time on Sun anymore. Okay, so these are the constellations that we typically know. So one of the interesting constellations, so you can see here some of this constellation. I'll be trying to show you some of the most interesting constellations. So just give me a second. So you can see here, you can see this is known as Pisces, so which is very famous. This is Aquarius. So this is Sagittarius. So we have a lot of Lupus and other constellations that are available. But yes, trust me, they have nothing to do with astrology. They are just used to divide the night sky into various segments or sectors, as our ancestors did, and we still use it for our reference. So if you see, these all stars can be joined to form some animals. Trust me, I find it very difficult how somebody can join them and get such interesting objects, but our ancestors were a lot creative. So yes, you can look into any side. So it's a Gemini and Aries, so that's what we call Pisces. So if you see here, one interesting thing, so this Aries, Pisces, Aquarius, Capricornus, then Sagittarius. So these all, if you draw, it comes under a straight line. Scorpion, Libra, Virgo, Leo, and then Cancer. So it's like a circle. You can see here Gemini, Orion. Then after that you can see here, so it's kind of a circle that forms here. So the point what I want to say you, or what I want to emphasize, is that there are 12 constellations that lies in our galactic plane, whereas there are actually 88 constellations, but not all of them lie in our galactic plane. So the 12 constellations that mostly we known is that we call it our zodiac sign. Well, there is nothing, the zodiac sign and the prophecies that people usually tell about the zodiacs are actually false. There's nothing truth in it, but there are 12 zodiac as far as I know. And actually what the zodiac represents is, like, if suppose I call he is an Aquarius or he is a Libra, so what does it indicate? Actually, it does not indicate any future or the person has to do something with zodiac. It represent when the person was born in a particular month, which constellation was at his or her horizon. So suppose if I am born in, let's say in November or December, then if I look into the horizon, or if I look into the night sky, which constellation will be at the center or at the horizon? So according to that, we divide it into constellation. So that how the basic notion of constellation came. It has nothing to do with astrology or the pseudoscience that has been spread today by various news channels and lot of shows that are currently going on. The stars do have an effect on our life. No, stars do not have an effect on your life. Nobody has an effect on your life unless you do. So trust me, trust astronomy, trust physics, trust science. There's nothing pseudoscience, and it's more interesting than you think. Well, I think that's all for today, and try exploring this interesting software. You will, I guess once you start using it, there are a lot of things that you can know about it. And in my next subsequent tutorials, I'll be telling you in details how to watch a particular comet or how to watch a particular target or a star in the night sky. Thank you all for joining me today. I hope you had a nice time. Please do like and subscribe my channel, and please share it. It's my earnest request. I'm an astrophysicist studying in an Indian research institute. And if you people have any queries about any astronomical phenomena or about anything that you want to know from an astronomer, you can just text me or just drop your comments or on my YouTube channel or on my webpage that is shared in my YouTube channel as well. So yeah, that's what I want from you. Please like and subscribe my channel. Thank you very much.